Hi, my name is Mark, and welcome to my channel, The Media Nerd. Today's video, I'm going to show you how to transfer an audio cassette tape using your PC. Now, I realize that I've done this type of video in the past, but I use a Mac, and there are more PC users out there than there are Mac users, so I thought this video would be helpful for you PC people out there. I am going to be using a tape deck by Ion called Tape to PC. And I was looking around and I realized that it's no longer being manufactured, but there are a few other types of tape decks on the market that you can purchase that's going to do the same thing. And I do have a link in the description to those different models. I'm also going to be using a software program called Audacity, which is a free download, and I will supply that link as well. So let's get started. Okay, here is the front of the tape to PC. We do have two different places we can put the cassette tape in. I always sort of choose the one on the right. So let's get our tape loaded up. And we have on the front, there's not too many options. I always leave the noise reduction on off. Now on the back of the tape deck, which is very similar to the other models you can find on the market, you have your USB connect, which goes right to the computer, and you have your gain control, which regulates the audio to the PC. You can go minimum or max. And this is what I like to use to regulate the audio. On my PC, you connect the USB on the top front. Other PCs may have it on the back, or if you're using a laptop, they could be located on the sides. Now that we have everything connected up, let's go ahead and get to the interface of Audacity. Okay, I'm at my PC, and let's go ahead and launch Audacity. And let's go to File. Let's do a Save Project As. And I want to be in my Volume E folder. And I'm going to do a new folder called Bat Mitzvah. Okay, make sure that is saved. Now what we want to do is go to Audio Setup and make sure that things are looking good here. So my playback device is Speakers Realtek, and those are the speakers that I'm using, so that looks really good. And the recording device is Line USB Audio Codec, and that's most likely what you want to use as well. The recording, we're going to just keep it at stereo as well. All of that looks great. Now up here, this is the record meter. You can slide this all the way to zero and you won't get any type of recording, or you can go all the way up to 100. Which is what I use, because remember there's a gain on the back of the deck and I prefer to use the gain. Okay, let's go ahead and hit record, which is that red button, and hit play on our tape deck. I don't have the tape fully rewound, I just wanted to get some audio recording. That does sound pretty good. I can hear some ambient audio in the back. Okay. Say this is all we want, and we can hit stop. We're gonna hit stop on our deck. Now you can see that the audio is a little low in the recording. What we can do to increase or amplify the sound is, first you want to go to select and select all. And then you want to go to effect and go to amplify. And it pops up with this little window here, and there's an allow clipping. So if you allow clipping, things are going to peek out on you when you do your adjustments. It's already setting the highest level that it can amplify the audio without peaking. So I'm just going to keep it that way. And we can hit apply. and see how it all just boosts the audio really nice. Now, if you want to try to clean up the audio and try to get rid of some of that ambient audio behind, you can do that. But remember, when you start messing with it, it's also going to mess with the rest of the recording. But let's see what we can do to clean this up. So here's sort of an ambient audio right through here. So I'm just going to select a piece or a portion. What I did was I just highlighted that little section, and I'm going to go to Effect and Noise Reduction. And I'm going to click on Get Noise Profile. That was it. It got the noise profile immediately. Now what I can do is go to Select All and go back to Effect and Noise Reduction and hit OK. And that is going to apply that noise profile to the entire audio clip. So let's see what happens. There. See, it did reduce everything else, but let's see how it sounds. It did a pretty good job. I mean, there was a little bit of him singing through this section here. You could still sort of hear it, but it did overall improve the audio. There's a lot of other different effects that you can do in Audacity. I mean, a ton of things, but I don't really want to go through any of that. I just wanted to give you the basic understanding of how to use Audacity and how to capture your tapes. You can go ahead and play with all of the other things as much as you possibly want. Now that we have that audio captured, we're going to want to export it so we can listen to it as an MP3 file or a WAV file. And what you do is just go to Export Audio. And right here under Format, it has MP3. You can save it as a WAV file or an FLAC file, which is a very, very large file, which is for professional use if you want to really have a large file to be able to play with. Most people choose MP3 because that's a good audio preset for using PC and Mac. Let's go ahead and find a folder. I already have Audio Test YouTube right here, but you can hit Browse and you can pick, hit Save and Export. It was that fast because it was such a small file. So let's go find that file and see how it sounds. And that is it. That's how you capture an audio cassette tape using your PC with Audacity. So that was pretty simple, right? Being able to transfer your audio cassette tape to PC. Now remember, I did use the Ion tape to PC, which is no longer being manufactured, but there are a couple other tape decks on the market that you can purchase, and I do have a link in the description to those products. Now, if you don't have this type of technology, or you don't have the time to transfer audio cassette tapes or any kind of media, I would love to be able to help you out. You can contact me by email at info@coloradospringsvideo.com, or you can go to my website, coloradospringsvideo.com. I do have a special order form on that site that you can fill out to mail to me along with your media. So thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Make sure to help support the channel by hitting that subscribe button, liking, and ringing that bell. You have yourself a wonderful day.